Hi, and welcome to this tutorial on MPFB eye materials. This is the fourth part of the series on materials. In this video, it is assumed that you have watched the prior parts. You can find links to these in the description of the video. In this video, I will describe the two options available for eye materials in MPFB. Before looking closer at the actual materials, we will also take a look at how the eye meshes look. In MPFB, you basically have two options for eye materials. To the left in the image, you can see an eye with a make skin material. To the right, there is an eye with the procedural eyes material. In a close-up, you can see the difference between these two. But in many renders, where the character is seen from a bit away, there might not be any apparent difference in the end. Thus, you might ask, what difference does it make to choose between these two? The make skin option should be familiar by now. In this approach, an image texture is used to specify the color. The upside of this is that it is simple and will not cause any confusion. It will work outside Blender 2 if you choose to export your character. Another upside is that if you have a higher resolution image, you can get lots of detail in the eye. The downside of the make skin option is that it is static. If you want a different eye, you will have to paint a new image. There is no particular control offered. This said, there are a bunch of common eye color materials available in the system asset packs, as well as a few available for download. In most cases, this should be sufficient. In the other approach, the entire setup is procedural. Contrary to the materials seen in the earlier parts of the series, the procedural eyes material does not make use of any image texture at all. The upside of this is that you have good influence over the details. You are able to dynamically change color and features of the eyes. The downside is that this is Blender only. Procedural eyes will never work outside Blender. What you should use comes down to your use case. Neither of the materials is in any way better than the other one. They are just different options that fit in different use cases. Anyway, before taking a look at the materials, we will need to have a brief discussion on eye meshes. In the system assets packs, there are two different meshes, one which is called low poly and one which is called high poly. Going only by name, it is not obvious what the difference is. Taking a closer look, we can see that there is the expected difference in mesh resolution. However, if you take an extra close look at the left eye, which is the high poly one, you can see that there are actually two layers of mesh. The outer layer is completely transparent in this image, but if you look at the vertices, you can see that some of them seem to hang in the air. Let's leave it at that. We'll come back to when that makes a difference later. Just keep in mind that the high poly eyes has both an inner and an outer layer. Now let's take a look at the make skin material. In the viewport, there's a character without eyes. Before adding the eyes, we make sure that the material model for eyes is make skin. Now we add the low poly eyes. The results look as expected. Now let's delete the eyes and instead add high poly eyes. The result is exactly the same. We will get back to why in a bit. But what if we want a different eye color? Same as with all other mesh assets having a mixed skin material, we can take a look in the alternative materials dropdown. So, quick, easy, and not many surprises. The make skin eye material will wrap an image texture around the eyeball. If you enable subdivision so you have a smooth mesh, both the low poly and the high poly will look exactly the same, as the outer layer will be invisible. Taking a look at the image texture, we can see the eyes. The outer layer faces will take the color from a part in the lower right corner. This part of the image has an alpha value of 0, making it completely transparent. Back in the viewport, let's delete eyes and instead do the same with procedural eyes. First, we make sure that we are using the procedural eyes material. Then we add a low poly mesh. Never mind the colors, we adjust those later. Now we delete eyes and instead add a high poly variation. This looks different. The reason is that the outer layer is now visible. Instead of having alpha transparency, the outer layer uses transmission. Unfortunately, you will need lots and lots of light and lots of samples for the light to properly distribute through the eyes when using high poly. In many cases, you might prefer to use the low poly ones to avoid this. I'll switch back to the low poly ones, since it will be easier to see what happens that way. Taking a look in the materials section, we can see we have a control panel for the eye material. Let's play with the colors a bit. Maybe we want green eyes. I'll get back to what the various sections are in a bit. Or maybe we want a larger eye. And maybe a different size pupil. Now, before digging deeper into the settings, let's discuss the parts of the procedural eye. Conceptually, you have an eye white and an iris. While not anatomically correct, the size of the iris will also include the pupil in the calculation. Thus, when modifying the eye white to iris ratio, it is actually the eye white to iris and pupil ratio. With a low value of this, you will see more of the eye white. With a high value, the pupil and iris will take up a larger part of the eye. Outside the discussion of the ratio to the eye white, the eye is divided into pupil and iris actual. The size of the pupil goes from 0 to 1.0, where the value is how much of the total iris plus pupil area is taken by the pupil. If you set the pupil size to 0.33, it will take up a third of the space given to the pupil and the iris in combination. If set to 0, there will be no pupil at all. The iris actual, that is, when not including the pupil, is divided into four sections, which each have a size. Section 1, the innermost ring, tapers from minor color to the pupil color. Then we have a large section with a random pattern of minor and major color. Then there's a ring with solid minor color. And finally, there's a section where the color tapers from eye white color to the outermost ring color. I'll set these colors to something with high contrast so we can see clearly what happens. Now let's play around a bit with the sizes. In total, the iris actual is always 1.0. So what you do here is set where on the range from 0 to 1 the section ends. The innermost ring always starts on 0. Now let's move on to the pattern. Conceptually, you have a random noise pattern, which is stretched in radial and clockwise direction. The scale should come as no surprise. A low value will give you big features, whereas a high value will give you small features. The radial multiplier is the stretch in the outwards direction. The clockwise multiplier is harder to see, but it shifts and stretches the texture clockwise around the pupil. Basically, you can use this as a random seed to get different patterns. The pattern can also be enhanced with a bump. Let's set all colors to gray so we can see better what happens. Anyway, these are the basics of the procedural eyes. The key point here is that since the material is procedural, you get control over the looks without having to manually paint a texture. The results are not necessarily better than if you use mixed skin. One important hint is that if you get eyes that look too dark in your scene, try to change to low poly eyes. This way, you will remove the outer layer. On the other hand, you then might want to make the eye white less white, so that it does not look overly bright. Before wrapping up, I'll just show more in detail how I made the reptilian eyes in the last video. First, I think it is a bit more ominous that the eyes are a bit black. Thus, we set the eye white. Then we'll want unnaturally large irises, so we change the ratio. Now we play around with the color. Yellow, orange, something seems appropriate. Finally, we'll increase the size of the pupil a bit, again to make it look unnatural. As a bonus, I'll just mention that you can save eye settings separately. If you go to the Manage Save Files, there's a section for eyes there. Here you can save, for example, your reptilian eyes. Then, when having new eyes, simply select the settings and apply them again. Anyway, that concludes today's tutorial. Thank you for watching and happy modeling.